Hello and welcome back to some more Football Manager 2021. This is part 38 of the Sir Alex Ferguson Challenge with Aston Villa. Today we take on Arsenal and Manchester City as we look to continue our title push, or at least the top four push for this season. I'm Joe, if you're new around here, make sure that you click that subscribe button for daily Football Manager content. So let's have a little look at how things have gone since the last episode, which was that 2-1 defeat to West Bromwich Albion. We then went on to win a 5-0 against FC Larte with Eric Bailly, Louis Barry, James Rodriguez and Max Ahrens getting goals there. We then lost 2-0 to Burnley, which was another awful result. Three consecutive away defeats in the Premier League. Not good enough. But we bounced back with a 2-0 victory over Tottenham with Ollie Watkins and Michy Batshuayi getting the goals, and then beat AAB 5-0 away from home in the Europa Conference League. Neymar getting a hat-trick, Ollie Watkins and Harry Maguire also contributing. And most recently, we beat Leicester 4-0 in the Premier League with Neymar and Jamie Vardy scoring and Ollie Watkins getting a brace there. So we've got Arsenal, we've got Man City, we've got the Feyenoord match in the middle of it as well. And you can see we're in 7th place with 28 points from 14 games. If we do win this, we go on to 31 points, which, you know, is there or thereabouts in the top four. Everton are hot on our tails as well. So, you know, it's a really close season, and it's a bit frustrating that had we won those three Premier League games that I think we could have won, if we'd won them, we would have currently been 4 points clear at the top of the league with a game in hand. So, yeah, that sort of shows the difference, really, of winning those games and having you know, a really good Premier League season. But let's have a little look at the team for today then. We've got Martinez in goal with Ahrens, Bailly, Nelson and Williams in defence. We've then got Grealish and Smith-Rowe in the middle of the park, and James Rodriguez and Bertrand Traore starting wide of Ollie Watkins and Neymar up top. So let's get into it then. This is going to be a tough match against Arsenal away from home. You know, this is a big test for us. If we can go out there and beat them, you know, potentially we can get back into this title race. But if we don't beat them, you know, the cracks are starting to show. And it'll be our fourth consecutive away defeat in the Premier League as well. And here's Otavio, gets it in, Saliba was there, but it was a good catch from Emiliano Martinez against his former club. And Martinez gets it away now, and here's Ceballos, good tackle from Smith-Rowe. Now Martinelli, here's Otavio, good ball forward, and Darwin Nunez has scored, and Arsenal already 1-0 up within the first 12 minutes. They just carved open our defence as if it was a knife through butter. Smith-Rowe, good effort from him, but yeah, just not good enough, and a beautiful ball through, and Darwin scores, and well, Arsenal are 1-0 up, and Leicester go to the top of the table very briefly there, team that we've just beaten 4-0 in the league, and you know, I think that just shows how close the Premier League is this year. But here's Neymar, nope, he can't find the same Pearson ball through to get through to Ollie Watkins. Here's Everton on the left-hand side now. What's he going to do with it? Well, he loses it, but gets it back straight away. And it is 2-0 now. Otavio with the goal. That's a bit of a disappointment, because Everton got it into the middle. And once again, just not a strong enough tackle. And it was William with the header, and then Otavio with the finish. And it's 2-0 to Arsenal now, and it's looking difficult to get back into it. But here's Grealish, gets it back to Victor Nelson, gets it forward but loses out straight away, and that's exactly, you know, what I'm talking about. We're just not efficient at the moment away from home. Grealish gets it wide but can't do anything with it. Here's Martinelli, now Everton on the left hand side once again. Oh, good save from Martinez. This could be a bit of an embarrassing result. Martinelli, oh, it's off the line. Thankfully. But you just look at how close it is and you just want to get in there, get in amongst it, but we're just not quite there at the moment. Here's Traore. Got plenty of space here, got a chance to maybe pass it forward, but he's going it alone and loses out, and that just sums it up so far for me. You know, he had plenty of opportunity to get it forward to Ollie Watkins, get us back into the game. We're very nearly 3-0 down there. Martinez is keeping us in it at the moment. So, corner to Arsenal. Otavio into the middle. Adebayo, oh, it's in. And Darwin Nunez has got his second. Wow, that was just sloppy. It really was sloppy, that. And Arsenal just slapping us about here. Oh, it's just depressing to watch. And, you know, we've only had one shot so far, which is just unheard of for us. And Neymar, again, not turning up to these games. It's not good enough. 3-0 at half-time. That was absolutely pathetic. It really was. So, Neymar, he's going out wide straight away. Bertrand Traore is coming off. We're going to stick Jamie Vardy on up top as a pressing forward on attack. James Rodriguez is going to come off, and we're going to stick on Riyad Mahrez on there instead. And we'll see what that does. A couple of changes at half-time. You know, we have scored 3 goals and a half against Arsenal before. Let's do it again. Grealish into the middle. It's away by William Carvalho. He has Brandon Williams now. Smith Rowe gets it forward towards Jack Grealish. That was a chance. That was definitely a chance. And Smith Rowe wants to come off. So I'm going to replace him with Ruben Loftus-Cheek. And although we've been slightly more respectable in this second half, it's still nowhere near good enough. Bailly gets it away. Vardy's there, but doesn't do anything. Here's Williams. Nelson gets it forward to Loftus-Cheek, but he loses out and just not good enough with the passing accuracy. And Ceballos nearly made it 4-0 there. Wow, Neymar, a 5.9. It's not often you see that, but he really is having a horrible time out there. Williams, Loftus-Cheek, here's Neymar. Loftus-Cheek, wide to Williams. Here's Jamie Vardy, and well, Vardy gets us a goal back with his 12th goal of the season. And at least he's turned up. He's finally had a chance today and managed to put it into the back of the net. It was a decent ball from Williams, actually. Vardy was there, and it was a first-time finish. 3-1. Can we make the comeback? If we can get a goal within the next couple of minutes, who knows? Neymar into the middle. Bison. Well, to be fair, that was a chance. And if we'd made it 3-2, I would have fancied our chances. Still got the ball here. Nelson. Mahrez. He has Mahrez. Oh, if only it was Ollie Watkins or somebody with that on the end of their boot. Grealish into the middle. Nope, it's away. Mahrez again. Eric Bailly. Nelson. Williams loses it. And that's end of highlight. But that could have really put the pressure on Arsenal as we go into added time. And yeah, it is going to be a comfortable victory in the end for the Arsenal. And you know, I think they were by far the better team there. And well, title race over, for us at least. Here we go then for the Man City match. A couple of changes that we've made. Jamie Vardy comes in, Callum McGregor goes out wide, and so does Ollie Watkins. Other than that, nothing else has changed, I don't think. Maybe Harry Maguire didn't play in the last match, so it's going to be an interesting one against City. You know, our home form is very, very strong. So, you know, if we're honest, we have a very good chance against Man City. I think we're going to have to come up with some sort of away tactic, maybe with a defensive mid in there or something to give us a little bit more solidarity away from home. But there you go, we're 1-0 up straight away here within a minute and a half. And it's Callum McGregor again with a header down to Jamie Vardy. That was terrific. Neymar with the free kick in. Maguire headed down, and it wasn't actually McGregor. I thought it was McGregor with a header, but it was Maguire. And Jamie Vardy was there, although this looks like he was offside there, Jamie Vardy. So maybe we've got away with that. I'm not entirely sure why there wasn't any VAR involved or anything, but we'll settle for it either which way. Good tackle. He has Militao. And, well, Bai gets it away. He has Vardy now. Vardy gets it forward. Neymar runs onto it. Neymar! And that is what he was scoring last season. And he just seems to have got the yips or something in front of goal. It's crazy what has happened to him. You know, it's crazy to say that about a guy who scored a hat-trick three matches ago. But, you know, he's... He just doesn't seem himself. But here's Watkins. Watkins on the ball now. Grealish. Nope. That was a poor ball. De Bruyne. Now to Sterling. Sterling gets it forward, but Williams is there to stop him. And now, is that Jamie Vardy? I think it was running after him. Edison gets it away. Edison again, boots it clear. Maguire loses it. That was reminiscent of the Gerrard slip. And, well, Haaland should have done a hell of a lot better there. That was a great chance for Manchester City to level the scores. But what a bonkers Premier League season this is. Here's McGregor on the left-hand side now. He seems to have, you know, really took to that position like a duck to water. Here's Watkins now. Watkins gets it forward, and Jamie Vardy with his second of the game. Third of the episode, and that is 16th. Goal of the season for Jamie Vardy, and we're 2-0 up now, and it was a wonderful through ball from Ollie Watkins that got it, and Jamie Vardy, the right man in the right place at the right time, and it's 2-0 to Aston Villa against Man City. Perfect start for us. Here's Aarons, and it's away by Rodrigo. Here's Grealish now. Grealish on the ball. McGregor. Here's Jamie Vardy. Vardy again. Williams. Smith Rowe, McGregor, nope, loses it, and that was poor. And now Man City on the counter attack. Here's Richarlison. Richarlison on the ball. Good tackle from Smith Rowe. That was terrific. Here's McGregor. McGregor gets it forward to Jamie Vardy now. McGregor, nope, loses it. Rodrigo to Sterling now. End to end stuff. Are we going to get it back? No, we're not. And it's a terrible finish from Raheem Sterling, and he'll be very, very disappointed with that. Will Raheem. So 20 minutes gone. Bit of a crazy start to this match. He has Theo. Theo into the middle. Richarlison makes it 2-1. Good header there from him. Fifth goal of the season. And Manchester City back in the match. It was a good header, that. Who suffered a knock? Grealish. Oh, dear. Yeah, I guess Ruben Loftus-Cheek comes on. Yeah, we'll do some man marking, why not? But yeah, you know, this would put us only 5 points behind Chelsea, which, you know, I'll tell you what, it's not bad, is it? It really isn't, but yeah, just anybody can beat anybody this season. It's a rather strange one. It's a rather strange one. Here's Sterling. De Bruyne, now Sterling again. De Bruyne. Camavinga, Richarlison, what a save. What a save from Emiliano Martinez there. And that is just terrific. De Bruyne into the middle, it's away. Here's Richarlison now. Good ball through to Sterling. Oh, it's a good tackle. Good tackle from Eric Bailly. And he manages to keep them out. For now, which is positive, really positive. So, 60 minutes gone. Brandon Williams looking rather tired. The problem is we haven't really got anyone to bring on for him, so it looks like Aaron's is going to come off. McGregor not having the best of games, unfortunately. So we'll stick on Mr. Bertrand Traore, one of the fan favourites. One of my favourites, to be honest with you. The goals he scored in season one and two were insane. But, yeah, we don't want to lose out here. Here's Maguire, gets it wide to Watkins. Now Sacek gets it forward. Here's Bertrand Traore, and that's going to be a penalty here. That was a horrible tackle from Militao. And looks like it will be a penalty. So it's going to be Neymar that's going to step up here. I don't fancy him to score. Oh, it was Jamie Vardy, actually, with his hat-trick penalty, of course. Who else could it have been? But he got on with it, and it went in. 17th goal of the season now for Jamie Vardy. He absolutely smashed that into the back of the net, and the 36-year-old has scored a hat-trick against Manchester City and hopefully sealed the 3 points for us. He has Watkins. Loftus-Cheek gets it forward, but Neymar nowhere to be found. De Bruyne gets it forward now. Stevanovic. And he has Jorge. Stevanovic, good block. Oh, don't like this. Don't like this at all. He has Theo Richarlison. Oh, it's off the post. That was super close to being back to 3-2 and back to the status quo almost. To what we were having 5 minutes ago. Neymar runs onto it. Neymar keeps going. Neymar's got it and pulled the trigger, but could not score. Is Neymar finished? That's going to be the big question at the end of today. Is Neymar finished? Certainly hasn't had the best start of the season. He's been perfectly fine, but not the man ripping up the Premier League like he was this time last year. But we have got a very positive result there against Man City. 3-1 at home. You know, our form at home is very, very, very strong. And if you have a little look at the Premier League, by the way, Jamie Vardy, let's give him a pat on the back, pat on the shoulder. Superb in front of goal. This man is insane. He's 36 years old. He's nearly 37. 37 in less than a month, and he scored 11 goals in 10 Premier League games. That is form to not be believed, really. You know, at his age, he's doing a fantastic job. But if we have a little look at the home record, you know, we're joint top. We've won every single game at home, along with Manchester United. But our away record, we're in the bottom half of the table. And that sums it up. We've only had one victory away from home, and that was against Southampton. And we were 2-0 down in that match. So that's definitely something we need to think about actually moving forward. Because we have got some big, big away games coming up. Away to Newcastle, away to Liverpool, and then away to Wolves and Watford. So, you know, we've got 4 away games in 5 league games that we need to get on top of. So that's something to think about as we go towards the next episode. But if you have enjoyed that, make sure you leave a like down below. It really does help out the channel. It means a lot to me as well. Subscribe to the channel for daily Football Manager content, and I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.